How do you choose your engineering major? Now that's a major question. I get asked this a lot and I really need to talk about it because I feel like we tend to overthink it. Stop overthinking. So I want to take away some of your worries and explain how I would choose my engineering major if I were to go back in time. Hey, my name is Anna and I'm a German mechanical engineer based in Sweden. When I was choosing my major, I honestly had no idea what the different types of engineering even were. So I just picked the most popular one, which in Germany is mechanical engineering. Now, my guess is that you probably don't want to do that, and that's fine. So I thought, if I were to do this again and do it in a more strategic way, how would I do it? And it really comes down to three things I would consider when choosing my engineering major. So that's what I'm going to share with you now. And by the way, at the end of the video, I'll also tell you one thing you should not consider when choosing your engineering major. But first, three things you should consider. The first thing I want you to consider is range. Range means how many different disciplines are involved in your major. So basically, how many different topics you're going to learn about. Now, if you already have a super specific dream job in mind, like you want to be an acoustics engineer for a headphones brand, then you can choose a very specialized engineering program that teaches you exactly that, if that kind of program exists. But then you're probably not watching this video, are you? So if you don't have this very specific dream job in mind, then you both want to keep your options open a little bit, and more importantly, you want to get to know as many different disciplines as possible so that you can figure out what you like and don't like. So if we imagine a scale from broad to narrow, where would the main different engineering disciplines fall? So on the very broad side, we would probably put mechanical engineering and industrial engineering. Then in the middle, we might have software engineering and civil engineering. And then at the very narrow end of the spectrum, we have specialized niche disciplines like acoustics engineering or biomedical engineering. The second thing to consider is the difficulty of the major. The difficulty is mainly decided by how difficult the math is that you're gonna need to do, and you can easily figure that out by going on the university website and looking through the course lists for the different majors. The more math courses are required, the more difficult it probably is. And the same is true the higher the numbers behind the course names are. So if a major only needs Calculus 1 and Linear Algebra, it's probably not as bad as if it also needs Calculus 2 or even Calculus 3 or 4. So if you're super worried about not being able to pass your classes, or if you're not really that interested in solving really difficult challenges, then you probably want to go a little bit lower on the difficulty scale. So let's rank some majors and make some people mad. On the easier side, we probably have civil engineering and industrial engineering. In the middle, we might have software engineering and mechanical engineering. And towards the more difficult side, we'd have chemical engineering and electrical engineering. But, and this is the third thing to consider, keep in mind that your interests have a really big impact on how difficult and tedious you perceive something to be. So if you're really interested in cars, you probably don't want to be a chemical engineer. And if you're not into business at all, then you don't want to be an industrial engineer just because it's supposedly easier. To help you understand which of the different disciplines might match your interest the best, I'm working on a part 2 for this video where I will explain all the main different types of engineering. So stay tuned for that. Now, a quick bonus point, what not to consider. Choosing your engineering major by salary is, in my opinion, incredibly stupid because you're already in a well-paid field. Now you just need to find the niche where you have the most motivation and drive to become really good. If you want more personal advice on choosing your engineering major, you can book a mentoring session with me. More information on that down below. And make sure to subscribe so you don't miss part 2 for this video where I explain all the different types of engineering. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it, and I hope to see you in my next video.
Stop overthinking.